कैलास शिखरे रम्ये शंकरस्य शिवालये देवताः तत्र मोदन्ते तन्मे मनःशिवसंकल्पमस्तु गगनवर्णम् पल्लवाजिनधरं नीलकंठं पिंछ विराजमानं इंदुशेखरं त्रिनेत्रं सांगं सायुध सवाहन सगणपत्नीकं मृगव्याधनामानं पशुपतये च नम उग्राय च भीमाय च नमो अग्रे वधाय च दूरे वधाय च नमो हन्त्रे च हनीयसे च नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यो नमस्ताराय नमः शम्भवे च मयोभवे च नमः शङ्कराय च मयस्कराय च नमः शिवाय शिवतराय च Today, our mind is full of Shiva. Yesterday only we could conduct Mahashivaratri Vratam. Vratam is that which is organized or conducted, executed with three important values and virtues, which is continuously performed, without break performed, and performed with a deep sense of commitment, a deep sense of consistency, devotion. These qualities are called dhriti in Bhagavad Gita. Whatever we do with a sense of yogic insight, with three C qualities, competency, consistency, commitment. One more creativity. That is how with this 3 plus 1, there means 4 values when they are added to our performance, it becomes the real dhriti, dhriti, dhriti. 3C. So English knowing people, so called modern scientific people, you can understand it easily. So whatever we do, if we do with creativity added every time, novelty, innovation added, commitment is added, consistency, nirantariya is added, then that work will be a better work. Result-oriented and all-inclusive, all-encompassing and long-enduring result it will fetch, it gives us to. So, what is that dhriti? Bhagavan takes one after one such values, life values. He took 12 such chosen domains for structuring sattvika, rajasika, tamasika. So, already we have covered how many type of shraddhas, sattvika, rajasika, tamasika. And tapas also partially we could cover. Yajna also we could cover partially. Here only in this Maitri Milan of Samskriti Bhavan. What is that sattvika tapas? Penance, rajasika and tamasika. Now we just now we are performing in the same mood. Our manovritti is already covered, engulfed in that Shiva Tattva. Shiva Shakti, Shiva Shakti. Shiva, okay, we become very sattvic. Shiva is actually that value which gives us that sense of sattvikata, positivity. Virtue-oriented approach. Fact-finding tendency, not fault-finding tendency. We must go for fact-finding tendency, not fault-finding. So, this dhriti is very, very important life value. So, Bhagavan says, that shloka you can just understand well. Dhritya yaya dharayate manaprāṇendriya kriyaha yogena avyabhicārinya dhritihi sa pārtha sattvika. Let us take it first. Then we go over rajas and tamas also. Because you know, this university got one more value added to its educational system and pattern. That is, guna inventory, call it. Guna, three guna system we have adopted in our TQM, total quality management. Total quality management becomes then only fully blossomed, user-friendly. When a dhriti value is very well added, suitably added. Dhriti, Shiva embodies that value. That very posture of Shiva on this hill, this rocky hill, nearby in Prashanti, that very stature embodies that dhriti, 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 no? What is that dhriti? Dhriti, normally we can say, oh, it is dharana shakti, holding capacity, or organizing capacity. Holding and organizing, holding everyone together, holding every organs of the body together, holding every karyakarta, every person, man, human resource available together. That is called organization, sanghatam shakti. That is dhriti. Dhritya yaya dharayate mana prana indriya kriya. So beautifully in Sanskrit. Mana kriya, prana kriya, indriya kriya. Three type of actions, three type of emotions, three types of vibrations we have in our body. Our manas will be having pulsation, its own type of pulsation. In that pulsation, there are two types of pulsation according to Vedanta. It is sankalpa, vikalpatmaka manaha. Positive pulsations and negative pulsations. In that positive pulsation, Shraddha, Medha, Prajna, Pratibha, Dhriti, like that. all these positive emotions and vibrations will be working well. If we channelize these things, we will be better performance, good performance. That means we will be successful performer in our chosen domain. हमारे कार्यक्षेत्र में हम सफल कार्यकर्ता बनेंगे. धृति से वो क्या है, मन क्रिया. मन में विकल्प ज्यादा हो, हम अच्छा कार्यकर्ता, अच्छा स्टूडेंट, अच्छा प्रोफेसर, अच्छा चांसलर, अच्छा वाइस चांसलर, अच्छा कोई नहीं होगा, वो सब अच्छे होंगे. सो अच्छा परफॉर्मर बनने के लिए, सीईओ चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफिसर बनने के लिए क्या करना है, धृति टू बी अडॉप्टेड. सो दैट अवर मन क्रिया, अवर मेंटल वर्क विल बी पॉजिटिवली चार्ज्ड, वी विल बी वेरी डायनामिक, वी विल बी वेरी बैलेंस्ड डायनामिक लीडर्स. दैट इज व्हाट नाउ नीडेड in all our chosen fields and domains. So, mana kriya and indriya kriya. Indriya kriya also, if we don't know how to say, how can we move our legs and hands? If we don't know how to walk, then we will be full of diseases. Sometimes because of imbalance in our foot, printings causes many problems. If we walk properly without your chappal, Hawaii chappal, certainly we will be free from many diseases. Your Hawaii chappal, your chappal made up of plastic, that is very dangerous. Because you know, our foot, our ear and our hand, these three are very important organs in our body, where all 72,000 nadis are interconnected. That is why we have this type of clapping and clapping and clapping in our programs. It's not only just a customary thing it is. Clapping is good. Not only clapping, even while offering namaskara to elders, we must do this. In our Tamil Nadu temple culture, we have a very beautiful custom and system. And they hold their ears and sit and get up. That namaskara is wonderful, very scientific. You have to hold your ear while offering pranams to God. That is very good. That is why while offering namaskara also we touch elders' feet with our hands and touch our ear. So that their pada is activated, our hand is activated, our ear is activated, so that all 72,000 nadis are activated. Full of vital forces they become. Even while doing namaskara, we have very much scientific things added to it. We don't know. We brand our rishis as the superstitious people, this and that. No. We are very great scientific people. We have a big lab. These are all very rubbish. Because it's so prejudiced. Even that very term, two term, we always use. This is traditional, this is scientific. You cannot do like that. Whatever is traditional comes from our Rishi Parampara. It is pakka scientific. It is purely scientific. You have impure science. Your science, your so-called modern science, which you call it scientific, every time you brand, that the scientific, it is unscientific actually. Now we must see that our science also became full of orthodox. Orthodoxical science, we call it science, science, science. No. There is no Raja Ramanna, great professor, even including Einstein, they told it is pure science, pure science. Now we must go for pure science in physics, pure science in... Pure science, yes. What is that purity in science? It must be eco-friendly. It must have no scope for no new innovations, no creativity. No, your labs are locked now. You kept every lab and every apparatus under lock. And everywhere you want justification and validation from your scientific instruments. Those instruments are rusted, outdated, very old. What is this nonsense going on nowadays, everywhere? So that we must go for pure science. Pure science, it is Rishi science. Rishi science. So Shiva Puja, it is sanctified by Rishi science. Our Yajna performance purified by our Rishi science. Our psychology, Indian psychology, sanctified by Bhagavad Gita and Yoga Sutra, it is pure science. Pure psychological science. If you just go and do japa of Sigmund Freud, Oscar Wilde, that is impure science. Now already many great scholars have come to know. Great scientists of world, global order, they are very humble. They say, no, our science reached the saturation point, sir. Please go out of here only. 15 great physicists were here in our campus. Under the guidance of E.C.G. Sudarshan, one who got that equal to Nobel Prize, that type of world, third world prize he got. He is in Texas, America. He and his supporters, great scientists of nuclear study, research, they were here for 15 days. There they called me to talk about Brahma Sutra. I was talking. I was telling Viyadashrute, Akasha Tattva, space, what that told in Brahma Sutra by Vyasa Badarayana. I just referred to one physics theory, the latest theory they call it, string theory, I referred to it. Immediately they stopped me. Telling, no sir, these are all half-truths, sir. Though it is latest, it has no base. Whatever Vyasa says, whatever great Rishi says, that is real pure science, sir. That is what E.C.G. Sudarshan tells. And great scientists of the world, nuclear research area, they tell. That is why we need not hesitate to use Indian Rishi science. It is not something tradition. It is pure science. With all pride we have to tell. At least from this S. Vyasa University, it is S. Vyasa. If just we tell all our great rishis, they are traditional people and we are scientific people, it will not be S. Vyasa. It will become no Vyasa. No. We must have that insight. Our Rishi culture is so pure, time-tested, as long as the moon and the sun will be shining, our Rishi culture and Rishi science will be evergreen, ever creative, ever innovative. That is all now proved, fact. All such great scientists with all humbleness, now they accept. That time has come now. So that dhati is sattvika, that is mana prana indriya kriya. We have to make it purified, sanctified by yoga. Dhritya yaya tharayati mana prana indriya kriya. Yogena anvyabhicharinya dhati sa patra sattvika. that dhati, so Shiva represents. So that Shiva was making penance. Wonderfully it is portrayed by Kalidasa in his Kumara Sambhava. Shiva was also meditating. He was there in the Himalayas. Most beautiful, Atyanta Jagadeka Shrestha Sundari Parvati Parvataraja Putri was serving. And Manmatha comes to test Shiva and creates that whole atmosphere supporting to that temptation. And he himself comes with five arrows. Manmatha uses all those arrows on Shiva. But Shiva harastu Chandrodayam Amburashi. When the moon shines as the ocean starts moving, immediately mind started moving, then harastu Chandrodayam Amburashi. His mind was like that, just like oceanic water on Purnima day. Immediately Shiva goes back and goes to test his own mind. Balavan Nigrihya Basma Vashesha Madanchaka. It is Kalidasa in a Kumara Sambhava. He could burn Kama immediately into ashes. That is Shiva Tattva. That is real sense control. That is dhriti. So that Shiva got all this. Mana, prana, indriya, manakriya, pranakriya, indriya, all under control. That is Shiva Yoga. That is Shiva Tattva. That is the real sanyama, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. In that sense, we here in this particular yoga university, we are to project Shiva Tattva. Not something chronic. This is yogic Shiva. One way of God is this dhriti tattva. Mana prana indriya kriya sanyama nigraha. That is what Shiva is. Let us remember Shiva Tattva. Sit properly. This Shiva, Yoga Shiva, embodiment of dhriti, sattvika dhriti Shiva, he is there. Let us contemplate. He is in front of, before our eyes, Shiva Tattva. Dhritiman Shiva. Sattvika Dhritiman Shiva. Mana prana indriya kriya nigrahi Shiva. Dharana Shaktiman Shiva. By this dhriti, one can burn all negative desires into ashes. Kama was burnt into ashes, not ignited. He is controlled. He, Kama, is sublimated, kept under control. For that we must have dhriti.
Yeah.